Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. So, I'm not sure you've been paying attention recently, but a stock on my watch list just reported their earnings and the stock got absolutely hammered after hours. I am of course talking about Beyond Meat. Now you guys know that this is a stock I've been watching for a while, and this came as somewhat of a surprise to me actually, to see the stock crash by this much, and in a single day too. So I thought we'd talk about why it crashed today, and also I'm going to talk about what do I think about the future prospects of the company, and whether or not I'm interested in picking up some shares now that the price is a lot lower than what it was before. So this should be a really fun video, and without further ado, let's jump in! So quick reminder before we begin, if you're in Canada, be sure to pick up your $10 when you sign up and invest your first $100 with Wealthsimple Trade, which is Canada's first and only commission-free trading platform. Or you can put your investment on autopilot and set it and forget it with Wealthsimple Invest. And the sign-up bonus for that is $50 when you deposit and invest your first $500. Now, okay, let's jump into why the stock crashed by so much in the first place. Well, it is because the earnings report came out and let's just say, well, it was not good, okay? So lately, I think that we've been getting a lot of earnings beats from various different companies, especially major companies in big tech. I'm talking about companies like Google, Facebook, Amazon, all of which have posted very stellar quarters and exceeded expectations. In fact, earnings have been so good that for some companies, the fact that they beat expectations actually causes the company's stock to go down because they didn't beat the expectations in an unexpected way. And if what I just said didn't make any sense at all, well, good, because it didn't make sense to me either, right? We're living in a time where literally a beat is not a beat. So, you know, this kind of reminds me of my time at the University of Waterloo, actually. So, while I was in Waterloo, we had to do these co-op evaluations, right? And at the end of each co-op term, we had to do these evaluations where your manager had to give you a rating. And the ratings range from satisfactory, good, very good, excellent, and outstanding. So, in my first co-op term ever, I was told by the co-op advisor at the university that you really want to aim for very good or higher because a good is not good. Like he straight up just said, a good is not good. And I thought that that's just how the University of Waterloo operates, but apparently this is how Wall Street operates too. When you beat earnings, it's actually not a beat unless you beat by like an outstanding amount, right? So with this in mind, you certainly don't want to miss expectations, definitely, right? So even when a beat is not a beat, you definitely don't want to miss. So that's exactly what happened to Beyond Meat though. They missed earnings and it caused the stock to crash. Specifically, revenue came in at $94.4 million versus expected revenue of $132.8 million. So it was quite a big miss. And earnings came in at negative 28 cents per share instead of positive 5 cents per share. So I think Wall Street especially hates it when they're expecting positive earnings and you put up negative earnings. So that certainly added to the disappointment. And further to add to the confusion, it was revealed that McDonald's will be coming out with their own plant-based burger called the McPlant. And funny name aside, it was unclear what Beyond Meat's role in this new burger would be. So for context, McDonald's had been partnering with Beyond Meat before on a pilot project here in Canada to roll out a series of plant-based burgers. And I've actually tried the plant-based burger, the plant-based McDonald's burger, which looks like this. And honestly, it's not that bad. I just wish it was a little cheaper, but taste-wise, it's about what you would expect, right? So if you like Beyond Meat, you're probably gonna like this burger. If you don't like Beyond Meat, this McDonald's burger is very unlikely to change your mind. Now, with respect to the Canadian Beyond Burger, though, when they rolled it out, it was just called the McDonald's Beyond Burger. So McDonald's is now rebranding it as the McPlant, though. So they're taking the word Beyond out of it. And I saw an interview on CNBC with the McDonald's CEO who made it pretty clear that they don't want to tie themselves down to Beyond Meat, right? So the reason why they changed it to McPlant is because they don't want to have to exclusively work with Beyond, as having a more flexible brand name such as McPlant, it opens the door to potentially working with other suppliers and other partners. So this of course came as a nasty surprise to Beyond Meat shareholders, who I think that many people were expecting McDonald's to kind of have an exclusive relationship with Beyond Meat. And it looks like this might not be the case anymore at this point. And Beyond Meat has argued that they helped McDonald's co-create the McPlant and work closely with McDonald's to make it happen. But honestly, guys, this is not a very convincing argument, okay? So that's like if your wife gives birth and you tell the doctors, I helped her make this baby. No, you didn't. You had like 30 seconds of fun and you rolled over and you fell asleep. That doesn't count, okay? So with that being said, what do I think about Beyond Meat? Well, long term, I actually still am quite bullish on the company, and I think that this stock could do very well in the future. I just think that in the short term, people had, got a little too excited and had too high expectations for the company. So if you were expecting the company to go to like $200 per share or something like that in the short term, well, you need to curb your enthusiasm, okay? So despite the revenue miss, let me just say that the revenue growth for this company is still kind of high. So it's still over 100% compared to the same quarter last year. And analysts are still expecting this company to grow revenues of around 50% or so next year. So what I like about Beyond Meat in particular, though, is the absolute scale of the company, which I think is unmatched by any other plant-based meats company, right at this moment at least. So here in Canada, there still aren't a lot of options for plant-based meats. So I just think that some companies are trying, but in my opinion, a lot of the bigger companies, they just don't get it, you know? So for example, Maple Leaf Foods, which is one of the biggest meat brands here in Canada, they have this weird like 50-50 plant-based and real meat mix, which is just hella confusing as to who is this supposed to be for, in my opinion. And if you look at other newer players in the market, there's this company called Very Good Butchers here in Canada, which I've heard very good reviews on it, right? But I really wanted to try their burgers, but right now, number one, the problem is that they're just swamped with orders. So shipping literally takes like 2 to 3 weeks. And also, it costs $15 of shipping, right? So I went on their website and tried to order a pack of burgers, but it literally costs more to ship the product to where I'm at than what the product itself is worth. So it just doesn't make sense for me to choose Very Good Butchers right now when I could just drive to the nearest grocery store and pick up a pack of Beyond Meat, which is pretty much available at any given grocery store that I've been to recently. And I'm sure that Very Good Butchers will ramp up in the future, but for now, they're not even in the same league as Beyond Meat, in my opinion, which is what I meant when I said that no one can match Beyond Meat in terms of scale. So I guess the big question is Beyond Meat beyond reach? So yeah, think about that for a sec. Anyways, I also do like the company's commitment to bringing down the price of plant-based foods to price parity with real meat. So that's something that the CEO, Ethan Brown, of Beyond Meat has repeatedly stated. So I think that logically it makes sense for plant-based foods to be cheaper since we're skipping a step in the food chain, right? So instead of growing plants and feeding it to an animal and eating the animal, we're just gonna eat the plants directly, which theoretically should be a lot more sustainable. So the problem, as mentioned before, is once again scale. So even though that Beyond Meat is ahead of the game in terms of scale in the plant-based world, it does appear that compared to meat companies like Tyson or Maple Leaf or any other like traditional players, Beyond is still far behind. So the traditional meat companies, they've been in the game for decades and decades, and you're not going to be able to catch up with them overnight. So yeah, that's just not happening, right? You're not just going to be able to waltz in there and match them in terms of scale because they've got like infrastructure and factories and everything already built, and they got like assembly lines basically. So yeah, I guess what I'm saying is that it's gonna take a lot to go beyond them in terms of scale. Okay, I'll stop. Anyways, with that being said, the big question is now, am I buying any shares of Beyond Meat, or have I bought any shares of Beyond Meat? And the answer to that is yes, I already bought shares of Beyond Meat. So today I bought 10 shares of Beyond at a cost basis of $123.81 per share. So I didn't catch the absolute lowest point in the day because I think it was a lot cheaper in the morning and I missed out, but whatever. It's a very small position size anyways. It's only about a $1,200 position, right? So I didn't go crazy on it. But yeah, we'll have to see where it goes. As I said, I believe that the shift to plant-based food is an actual trend and it's not just a fad. So I do think that the plant-based foods category is here to stay. And I think that in the long term, I'll do pretty well on these shares considering that Beyond Meat is doing really well and still putting up really high growth despite the earnings and revenue miss. So anyways, that's it for today. I'll leave it at that. Be sure to hit the like button if you enjoyed the video and consider subscribing if you like this series. Be sure to follow me on Twitter and Instagram, links down below in the description for those. With that being said, I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye!